Hi guys, my name is Demas, Rusli, and today we're in New York City and I'm going to be showing you 5 tips and tricks for mobile photography. So today we're going to be using the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus because it's the phone I'm currently using, but these tips and tricks can be applied to any phone. The first tip is to set up your camera settings. On the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, the quickest way to turn on your camera is to just double tap the power button. Then you're going to hit the settings in the camera app and then scroll through to adjust all your settings. Specifically, you're going to go to save options and then you're going to turn on raw copies for pro mode and ultra wide shape correction. Then I also like to turn on my grid lines to 3x3. Then go back to the main camera page and select 3x4 ratio to get the maximum image quality possible. Tip number 2 is to utilize all 3 cameras on the phone, the super wide, the normal, and the zoom. Most phones these days have these 3 cameras, so you want to utilize all 3 options to just get more flexibility in your photos. For the standard camera, you can use the pro mode to get raw photos. Tip number 3 is to find unique angles and compositions because your phone is small and it can fit in lots of different places. One bonus tip is when you're shooting reflections of puddles, you can actually flip your phone upside down so that the lens is actually closer to the ground. So we're in the financial district of New York City, let's just go out and try to shoot some photos. When you're shooting a panorama, you can also do a vertical panorama. And I'll show you how it's done. So we're here on Manhattan Bridge and this is going to be tip number 5 and it's going to be a night photography tip. So not only should you keep your camera still on a tripod, but you should also use pro mode to get the best quality image. For this, the settings I've gone with are ISO 50, f2.4, so that we can increase the shutter speed to about 2 to 4 seconds. Then you're just going to tap the screen to focus. But the biggest tip here is to actually use a remote so the camera doesn't shake when you're taking the photos. On the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, you can actually use the S Pen as the remote by pressing the button on the pen. But on other phones, you can use the volume down button on the headphones. Yeah, that's it. So let me just show you how it's done. Alright guys, because we shot everything on mobile, we can actually edit everything on the go. And so today, I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to edit this on the train using the S Pen. Okay guys, I hope you found those 5 tips useful. Let me know in the comments below which tip you found the most useful. If you like this video, please hit the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe button. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.